7 years ago today, a round of deadly tornadoes devastated the state.
On May 3, 1999, 66 tornadoes broke out in Oklahoma, Texas, and Kansas. The worst, an F5 that touched down near Chickasha and cut a deadly path all the way up to Midwest City. The 301-mile-an-hour winds were the strongest ever recorded. The twister ripped through Bridge Creek, Del City, and more, killing 44 people and destroying more than 300 homes. The damage was more than $1 billion.
You still see those pictures, Rick. I know a lot of time has passed, but boy, they've made a lot of changes.
And those changes, Paul, all have been made with the whole idea of saving lives.
The May 3rd, 1999 tornado outbreak was one of the most violent on record. There were more tornadoes in Oklahoma in one 24-hour period than we average in an entire year. It's been more than a decade now since that turbulent day, and advancements in technology have occurred.
One thing that has evolved over the last 11 years is weather radar, including our own Advantage Doppler HD. KOCO was one of the first stations in the entire nation to upgrade its radar processor. That allowed us to see storms in much greater detail than what we had back on May 3rd, 1999.
The National Weather Service has thus changed the way they issue warnings. Rather than an entire county getting highlighted for a storm, only a portion of the county will be under a warning.
One immense change over the last 11 years, the internet. We now use it to receive and send out weather information. Here's a classic example. This is called NWS Chat. It is a direct link to the National Weather Service office in Norman.
The internet obviously helps you at home as well. You can access our interactive radar. You can also go to our live wire. It's sort of an exchange of information in real time.
So all of those factors coming together means that you've got more information to deal with. But here's the deal, folks. Tornado safety comes down to knowing what to do and where to go in the event of a tornado. And that's why we're here, to help you out. That's why we always say, stay with Eyewitness News 5. We will keep you ahead of the storms. And hopefully we won't see something like May 3rd for a long time. But you know what? It could be just around the corner. It could be 10 years down the road. It could be 50. You never know. But with Oklahoma, you always know that at some point you're going to be dealing with these.